Hi, I'm Dr. John Shim, an orthopedic spinal surgeon, and today I'd like to discuss how to read a lumbar MRI. As many of you know, MRI is a specific study used to closely examine various body parts. It has lots of applications and can give a very detailed look. It's useful to identify findings to your lower back or the so-called lumbar spine. To understand how an MRI works, typically you're placed into a cylinder. Magnetic beams are then fired from the cylinder into your body. Magnetic beams start as parallel energy, but once it hits various parts, the magnetic beams get scattered in very specific patterns. The scatter is dependent on the nature of the tissue hit by the beam. To give you an example, muscles will scatter in a certain direction. Other tissues, such as nerves and ligaments, will also scatter in another direction. And firmer and harder tissues, such as cartilages and bones, will scatter in another direction. Scientists have figured out how to measure the scatter, and by measuring the scatter, they can make a three-dimensional reconstruction. MRI studies are excellent tools to reconstruct your body parts on a diagnostic study. Radiologists typically look at spine MRIs in several different planes. The two main planes are the axial plane and the sagittal plane. The axial plane is a cross-sectional view from the top of the body. I like to call it the bologna slice view. If you've ever been to the deli counter, the bologna loaf is placed onto the slicer. The cross-sectional view is similar to the axial view. As you can see on the screen, that is the axial view of the lumbar spine. Anteriorly, or the front, is the vertebral body. Posteriorly, or the back, is the posterior spinous elements. In the middle is a round space called the spinal canal. Within the spinal canal, we can see individual nerve roots floating within the spinal sac and the exiting hole for the nerve going down into the legs called the foramen. The sagittal plane is also a cross-sectional view, but this is from the side of the body. The best way to look at the axial view is to look at the side view of the spine and again take thin slices from the side to the middle of the body. In the sagittal view, we can see the vertebral body in the front. We see the posterior spinous processes in the back. And in the center, we see the space, which is a tube of water called the spinal sac. And within the sac, we can see individual nerves that are exiting from the spinal cord. As we go through various slices of the sagittal view, we can also see the foramen. To fast forward your understanding of the relationship between the axial and sagittal views, we'll superimpose the axial views on the sagittal view and reconstruct the spinal anatomy. By doing this, we have accelerated your understanding of the relationship between the axial and sagittal views, and now you have a much better understanding of the anatomy of the spine, as well as how the MRI can be used to identify specific areas of the lumbar spine. Of course, this is an oversimplification of how we read the MRI. Radiologists and spinal specialists spend years learning the nuances of the MRI studies. There are different signaling sequence parameters that better highlight water content or fat content or inflammatory responses. The simple MRI reconstruction does fast forward most of your understanding of how the MRI of the lumbar spine is read. Once we understand what is considered normal, we can then see the difference between the normal and things such as disc herniations, spinal stenosis, broken bones, degenerations, tumors, and infections. This is Dr. John Shim. I hope this video has simplified how to look and read a lumbar MRI. Thank you.